On Thursday, June 26, 2025, the world of science has once again been shocked by two astonishing geothermal phenomena, the eruption of Steamboat Geyser in Yellowstone National Park, and the dramatic and lasting 26th eruption of Kīlauea Volcano in Hawaii. The events have caught the attention of scientists because they both originate from very different geothermal systems. These two events are not just ordinary natural phenomena, but grand displays of two Earth-like forces acting at nearly the same time, literally changing the landscape of the planet's surface in recent times. Yellowstone National Park once again witnessed one of the most powerful geothermal phenomena on the planet. On a seemingly calm morning, with dew still in the air and nature still steaming, a massive explosion suddenly erupted in the distance. Within seconds, the sky above the Norris Geyser Basin was filled with a towering plume of steam and hot water. Steamboat Geyser, the world's tallest geyser, erupted more powerfully than ever before, breaking the record for the highest eruption ever recorded. The eruption on June 26, 2025 was no ordinary eruption. Superheated water, thick steam, and tiny rock fragments shot into the air with earth-shaking force. The plume is estimated to have reached more than 1,120 feet, about 341 meters, a new height that surpasses all previous eruptions since modern observations began. Scientists from the United States Geological Survey, USGS, have confirmed that the height of the water jet from the eruption, taller than all the trees in the surrounding area, is officially the highest eruption in Steamboat Geyser's documented history. Thousands of visitors were inside the park when the eruption occurred. Many stood still, awed by the sheer power of nature. But hundreds more were seen running from the main viewing area, avoiding the splash of hot water and the potential dangers of a sudden eruption. Minutes after the eruption, Steamboat Pond appeared to undergo a suspicious change. According to Michael Poland, head of the USGS Yellowstone Volcano Observatory, the surface of the pond was changing and boiling in a way that we've never seen before. This could be an indication of underground pressure changes. The changes provided valuable clues to geologists studying the underground heat patterns and pressure shifts that power Yellowstone's hydrothermal features. Despite the spectacular eruption, there were no injuries among visitors, and park rangers quickly directed tourists away from the danger zone, while others watched the natural wonder from a distance with a mixture of awe and tension. Meanwhile, more than 4,000 miles away, Kīlauea in Hawaii is once again flexing its muscles. In its 26th eruption of its 2024-2025 activity cycle, lava shot 1,250 feet, about 380 meters, into the air, producing fire fountains that electrified the tropical night and permanently altered the surrounding landscape. Episode 26 and the ongoing eruption at the summit of Kīlauea was another thrilling spectacle for onlookers at Hawaii Volcanoes National Park. The eruptive episode lasted about 8 hours before ending on June 20th. Scientists with the USGS Hawaiian Volcano Observatory have since confirmed that lava fountains from the north vent reached heights of up to about 1,250 feet, or 380 meters, which is a new fountain height record for this eruption. To clarify, this record only pertains to the current eruption, which started on December 23, 2024. Lava fountains erupted during certain previous eruptions, like Kilauea Iki in 1959, for example, have reached greater heights. Tephra from these recent fountains have been covering the nearby land outside of the caldera. In this photo, a geologist surveys the new tephra cone that now covers part of the closed crater rim drive. The cone is over 65 feet, or 20 meters, above the pre-eruption ground surface. Recent plumes generated by these episodes have also reached heights of up to 20,000 feet or over 6,000 meters. The burst of volcanic ash and gas associated with episode 26 was detected by local Doppler radar and prompted a special weather statement from the National Weather Service. Residents downwind, including those in Pahala and Wood Valley, were warned of potential ash fallout. It's important to note the difference between the plume and the lava fountain itself. As this photo shows, the plume is many times higher than the fountain. The plume usually contains high levels of water vapor, carbon dioxide, and sulfur dioxide. A recent time-lapse video produced by the Hawaiian Volcano Observatory shows the cyclic nature of this episodic eruption. Currently, there is another pause in activity, although all signs indicate another episode is likely to occur. Scientists say the preliminary forecast window for the start of episode 27 lava fountaining is between June 28th and the 4th of July. Although Steamboat Geyser and Kilauea originate from different geothermal systems, hydrothermal and magmatic, they are both the result of the accumulation of the Earth's internal thermal energy. Scientists from the University of Colorado and the Hawaiian Volcanological Observatory note that while there is no direct link between the two phenomena, their simultaneous occurrence may indicate a global pressure change in the Earth's mantle that is occurring on a very large and rare scale. From Yellowstone's superheated steam explosions to Hawaii's dance of fire and toxic gases, these two phenomena demonstrate that the power of nature is not only awe-inspiring, but also shaping new geologic history. The scientific world is not only amazed, it's compelled to learn more about the Earth's soul at work beneath the surface.